Hi guys, it's Jody. Today's video, I'm gonna be doing another swipe. But before we get started with that, I just wanted to come on here and tell you thank you so much. I have hit 5,000 subscribers and I'm absolutely floored. Like you have no idea. When I started this channel, my intended purpose was just to help others out with the blooms technique. When I first started with the blooms technique, there wasn't a lot of places to go and look because it was so new to try and expand on it, or, you know, what products work well in the United States as opposed to Australia or any other place on this planet. But that was that's still the goal of this channel. You know, I'm kind of expanding upon it a little bit more, but I just wanted to thank you from the bottom of my heart that I can't believe I hit 5,000 subscribers. I didn't think I'd ever hit 1,000. So thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Now, with that said, today's swipe, I got a new tool at the Dollar Tree and I'm excited to give it a go. So, and it's going to be a little bit different. I'm going to do some negative space. I don't do a lot of negative space and I want to brush up on it a little bit. So let's go have some fun. All right, for today's video, I am working on an 8x10 canvas and I have it taped on the back and you can see I put paint here and here. That's just the pillow paint. I'll just take a little bit from my stick and run it on. I've had a few more questions about how I secure the canvas to the spinner, especially when the spinner is dry. Just put a little bit of paint down, the pillow paint down, and then just press it and it's not going anywhere. I know others that use double-sided tape, or just taking, you know, one-sided tape and flipping it just to make it stick. I've not tried that way. To me, paint is just easier. So give either one of those a go. Usually after I do a painting, there's plenty of paint on the spinner, so I don't have to put any more paint on. But that's how I secure the canvas to the paint. So again, this is an 8x10 and I'm going to be doing a swipe. Surprise! I got a new to me tool from the Dollar Tree. This was actually in the kitchen section. It was labeled as a cookie spatula. And so I was going to put the cell activator on here and kind of swipe a little bit differently on this canvas. So you'll see as we go along what I'm going to do. And I will let you know all the colors that I'm using. And the pouring medium that I used is the Infinity Josonia mixed at 3:1. And all the ingredients are in a snapshot at the beginning of this video and also down in the description box below for anybody who wants to take a snapshot of the ingredients, paints, all that good stuff. All right. This pillow is the Glidden Premium Eggshell today. Just a little bit. I think that's going to be good for now. I'll fill in. If I need a little bit more on the edges, I will. But I'm going to kind of do a little, maybe a little whirly pattern. And I'm not going to go all the way to the edge since I have this different spatula type thing I'm trying to use. All right. Let's see. So the first paint I'm going to put down is, you've seen this before, my new favorite hot pink, Vallejo. This is their fluid acrylic and it is fluorescent pink. I just have a tiny bit left and I just wanted to use it up. So that's why I added it to this piece and I'm just going to put it on the bottom, but that's the consistency of it. And I think we're going to go just like that. Oh, I'm just going to put the rest of it on there. And then my next color, I have used the Golden Fluid Iridescent Bright Gold. And I added, I had mixed this a long time ago, and I had mixed this gold up to try to recreate something else, just on my own. And I had put in just like maybe an eighth of a teaspoon of the Perlex Aztec Gold, just to give it a little bit more richness. I had originally done it that way a long time ago, so I figured, well, all right, we'll just do it that way instead of just using the golden. So there's that consistency. All right, the next color is Primary Elements, the Color Art Hot Cinnamon. And this is what it looks like in the jar. It looks more like you're gonna get gold, but when you mix it up, it is definitely hot cinnamon. It's been mixed up for a little while, so it's not running off as nicely off the stick as I would like it, but I want to use it up, so we're just gonna go with it. I don't want too much. I don't want it to take over. And my next color is going to be by This Little Piggy. It is Meteorite. Oops, sorry about that. Meteorite. And it's kind of like a silver gold. I love this. That's what it looks like mixed up. It's kind of like in one light you see more gold, and in another light you see more silver. It's really cool. Might get a little bit messy here just because I feel like it. I think that should be good. And let's see, my next color is going to be Josonia's Dioxazine Purple. I don't want to put a lot on here because for once I don't want the purple taking over. It always does. That should be good. And then my last color is PBO Studios Acrylics. What is this? This is the Iridescent Blue Green. They have a green blue as well, which looks similar, but this is the blue green. And that's what that one looks like. I want to put a healthy amount of this on. So we're going to pour it. Good. All right. I'm going to use two cell activators today. I'm still getting rid of cell activators from my paint brand comparison with the Australian Floetrol. So my black cell activator is going to be the Atelier Mars Black. And it's mixed 4-to-1 with the Australian Floetrol, but that's the consistency. And then my white cell activator is the Blickrylic Titanium White. I only have a little bit left. And this is mixed with the Australian Floetrol 4-to-1. That's what that looks like. So I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to go this way on the tool. I'm going to put black first, and then I'm going to put white this way. I have to do it off camera really quick because I don't have any space here. I don't want it to drip on the canvas. All right, that's how I have it on my spatula here, and I think I kind of want to go just kind of move it along. We're just gonna go with it. See what happens. I don't know if I had too much on there. I just didn't push down hard enough. But we'll make them come out. I don't know about you, but I like the effect of having the pillow paint kind of come through with the white cells. It kind of breaks it up a little bit. I think it's kind of cool. I am digging that. Might want to bring this down just a little. See what happens that way. It's going to go off. I'm going to tilt it and kind of spin it a little over at the spinner box, but I want to move out this paint here just to give it a little help. There's enough paint on here. All right, I will meet you over at the spinner box. Woo! This is colorful. I love it. I can see just about every color in there. I feel like I just want to bring that up just a little bit more. There we go. And I'm gonna spin slowly. Because I like the composition and I don't want to, I wanna leave some negative space too. Bring this down a little. I'm a bit newer to negative space. I've done a few, but I haven't done a lot. Normally it's the whole canvas. And it gets to be a little tricky. I wanna try and get that some of that blue off right there. But I'm really liking the composition and all the colors. Yeah, this is super cool. Ah, look at that. I don't want to go too far more. I don't want to point. What happened a few videos ago? Actually, that blue up there isn't too bad. I like the these white cells on the corner here. And I like how this attaches and this attaches. But I don't really want to lose any more. I might either modify just a little wispies in or something, but I don't know if I want to put some white paint on here. Actually, you know what? I think I kind of do at least just a little bit, just to take some of it off. Now it's not so, I don't know. Do I get rid of all of it? Maybe. All right, that's it. That's better. I like that better. Bring this down. A little spin just to even off that corner just a little. Get some paint on there. There we go. This is so cool. It's so shimmery too. All right, I think we're done here. I think this is good. See what I mean about the paint on the spinner now that I've done this one? If you're gonna do another one, you'll have plenty. Plenty. All right. Here is that one. I'm gonna get cleaned up and I will bring you over for the flyover of this guy. All right, here's the flyover of this guy. Got a lot of sparkle going on, and I'm really pleased that all the colors showed up in good proportions. I love that right there. The red with the gold and the purple. And this little cell, the hot pink with the meteorite. I just love it. Yeah, this was a really good mix. I don't feel like any color dominated. And see, I really like when the pillow paint comes through a little bit. Not obnoxiously so, but a little bit. I did kind of clean that up a little. And I'm glad I took off that blue corner there. I like it white. So that is what she looks like. I'm going to let this dry and I will be back to show you the results in a little bit. And I'm back to show you the dried results of the piece you just saw me do. And it dried beautifully. First I'll show you here. This is what it looks like whole. But then those sparkles in there. I am totally going to resin this one. It dried just beautifully. I did have an oops up here. This was where that blue was. And there was a line here, but I came down a couple hours later to check on it. And unfortunately, there was a ladybug that got stuck in there and I had to get it out. So I feel really bad. That's my ladybug mark. But I think my favorite part is the purple with the pink and the blue over here. But I just love all of it, really. And I love the shimmers. tell me what you think in the comments below. I had fun with that tool, that little cookie spatula. I'm gonna get, I do have some more palette knives. Let me see. I've got a plethora of them here that I'm gonna experiment with in future videos, doing maybe some more negative space as well as full-on swipes. I've also got, if you see in the background, I've got a squeegee that I've been chicken to use because the handle is kind of weird, but I'm gonna have to give it a go. So with that, I hope you enjoyed this video. I really had a lot of fun with this. Thank you so much again for the 5,000 subscriber mark. I honestly, it is truly, it's because of you. And so thank you so, so much. So with that, please like, share, and subscribe. And I will see you guys next time. Thanks so much for watching.